Hans dies.
I feel that we've reached a turning point tonight.
Yes. Good luck on your assignment. But you're permitted to leave.
Hans dies.
Kill him if you can. Maybe he'll surprise us both.
Hans dies.
So he's dead. Farewell, Lord Regent. I've thought about trying to get close to you again. Just to put a piece of sharp metal in your eye.
Hans dies.
Someone beat me to it. Someone very dangerous, it seems. Good riddance to you, sir. So many schemes you had, and so many contracts. How many people did I kill for you?
must be in that basement.
I see you've got the barrier on. About time. Would have been done sooner if my bug is lighting that up. How many times have I asked them?
Please, no! Oh, it's you, Corvo. Thank the stars. We all thought you'd been killed, except for Samuel. He seemed sure you'd survived. I saw him on the river shortly before the killing began. He was smart enough not to come ashore, but I'll bet he's still out there, looking for you, is my guess. At first, Pendleton said it was time for our bonus. Havok stood behind them, and at the signal, he shot them each in the back of the head. Just like the target drills he used to. Lydia barely had time to scream. I would be dead too. Except Wallace told me I wouldn't be getting anything. Pendleton kept apologizing, saying that no one could ever know about the things they'd done. Martin was drinking and seemed sad. The Admiral was about to shoot Callista. Then he mumbled something about owing her uncle, Captain Curnow, a debt. They said it was time for Sokolov and went off to his cage. I don't know what happened after that.
Penetrate the workshop. Close them tight. We think Piero Joplin's inside.
Errant dies.
There is evidence that Anton Sokolov.
Hey, come out, and I'll go easy.
I know you're somewhere around here.
There you are.
Help me find him.
You're here somewhere, scum.
We know you're here.
I gotta get back right now.
I'm going back.
Eyes sharp. Call out to each other if you spot him.
Refreshing to converse with someone on my own level.
I couldn't agree more. Your expulsion from the academy was a crime against natural philosophy.
Which you might have pointed out at the time, but it's pointless to hold a grudge. I want to ask you.
Corvo, good to see that you still breathe. The city would not be the same if you were not with us. I've completed Piero's work on an arc pylon, but only just.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, nearly rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes. I've attuned it so that we will be safe from the functions of the device. It will only trigger in the presence of our enemies. This arc pylon is more powerful than the older design. It will function at a greater range, striking down our foes while ignoring us. I need my final sequence, which is recorded in the blueprint for this device. Havelock was inspecting it before the killing started. Return the blueprint to me. It was in his bedroom before he left. Hopefully, it's still there. You may navigate the fields of battle with ease, but I'll do what you want, but ask quickly.
Joke.
Pylon is complete. Now to activate it.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, merely rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes.
What is your opinion, Corvo? Far away before any of them regain their senses. All is ready, Corvo. All that remains is plugging in a whale oil tank to power it. Will you do the honors?
When this arc pylon is charged, no one will dare come near us.
Thank you. description. A device like this will ensure Dunwall's security for a century.
Corvo, I can't believe you're alive. They killed everyone, Corvo. They killed everyone to cover it all up. Then they took Emily with them and they left. I couldn't do anything to protect her. Please find her. Make her safe. All his talk of being an honorable military man, but Havelock will use Emily like a puppet to his own advantage. Something changed in the Admiral as soon as the Lord Regent. It had been building up. Martin was acting strange, going quiet if any of us were near, whispering late into the night with Havelock and Pendleton while you were out doing the real work. I think they realized they were one step away from holding the same position the Lord Regent had, and worried they'd be held accountable for what they did here, as the Loyalists. They would have killed me too, but Havelock spared me. Out of respect for my uncle, I believe. Please, talk to someone and let someone must know where they're going. Find Emily. She's suffered through so much, and she's got no one else on her side except you. Samuel set this here in case you returned. You can use it to call him. He said he'd come quickly. Hopefully there's a place he can dock where the watch won't see him.
Thought I'd find you here. Never pays to bet against you, does it? I saw the signal. I knew you'd be back, Corvo. I knew it. We'll need to get out of here soon. The Admiral controls the military now, Martin's high overseer, and Pendleton's in favor with the aristocracy and Parliament. They need Emily, of course. But if Havelock senses that it's all about to fall down around him, who knows what he's liable to do? Good. Then it's one more trip across the river to where it meets the sea. That's where the Lord Regent was building his new lighthouse. Ought to be something to see. The island is a bloody mess.
Looks like they fought. Maybe over Emily. Just after they landed. I bet the Admiral's got her locked up in a lighthouse somewhere.
If Pendleton's lost the first round, he's probably dug in someplace, doing his best to drink himself to death.
I suspect it's Martin who's got the lighthouse under siege. They turned on each other at last.
So the Admiral's power mad, Martin's a snake, and Lord Pendleton is a coward.
And you. I'm a little disappointed, Corvo.
It's like you've gone out of your way to be brutal. It's been interesting traveling with you, but this is the last time you'll see me, sir.
Goodbye.
My only hope is that Emily comes out of this all right.
Out, Corvo.
I'll let you go this once. I'm warning you, Corvo. Out of the boat.